Now we're shifting gears into receiving an offer. And this is where everything shifts. And what you've been waiting for is here in your hand. And this is the time for you to evaluate whether you want this or not. And if so, on what terms? So when you receive the offer, even if you think, no, just ask for some time to deliberate. It just helps so that then you're responding in a way that you will, in a way that feels really integrous, so that you're preserving, if you want, any professional relationships with the people that you've been through this process with. So, one comment and two questions you should reflexively do when you receive an offer. First, thank you. Let them know that you're pleased because it's a compliment to you. And if you're excited about it and you think you're going to take it or negotiate it, then add some enthusiasm into that and tell them why you're glad and what pieces of the interview resonated for you and what you're thinking is a really good match. Also, ask two questions. Ask for the offer in writing via email because you're going to want to review everything, all of the benefits that are going to be attached to it. And ask for clarity about the timeline so that you know exactly when you need to get back to them. So here's a script about, what to say while you're receiving this call, or if you're sending them back an email. And also, just to know, this is the time to pat yourself on the back and feel good about what you've done. So now you get to decide, is this something that I want? And so there is a document included in this lesson for you to evaluate the offer. And I've included both a Word version so that you can populate those fields, and also a PDF just in case you don't have Microsoft Word. So both, it's the same document, it's just two different formats. And really, there are four choices that we're going to talk about. One is just nope, thanks, but no. If you will accept, but only under specific conditions. And usually, this has to do with either salary or remote and other features that are really important to you. Third option, you can accept and request more without killing the deal. And then the last option is to accept the offer as is. So we're going to talk about the first and the last in this particular lesson. And then in the next module, we'll talk more about the details around negotiating. So, as you're deliberating about this opportunity for yourself, here's a list of questions to reflect upon as you are evaluating the offer that they've extended to you. So, review this and think about whether it's something that you really want to take on. And also think about whether it's a good match for you and in your long-term progression and whether you think you can do better. So if you decide this just is not for me, here's what you do. You contact them. It's best if you can do this over the phone. If you decide, I'm just going to deal with this via email, that's fine. I think though, just for professional courtesy and for long, a lot of industries are small and you may encounter these people again. And so you could give them the courtesy of doing a phone call. So the protocol is express gratitude, really appreciate that you have given me this opportunity and extended this offer. And then let them know if it's the salary was not high enough, or if you feel like there just isn't enough growth potential for me. You know, I just isn't a time for me to move my family. And be careful about this and how you deliver this, because if the salary was published and known to you through the entire process, you don't want them to be thinking, wait, why did we spend all this time with this candidate? So you also can just be vague about it. It wasn't a good fit for me at this time. If you feel like, yeah, game over, I'm not really interested in anything further. So just give them a little bit of a, it's just not a great thing right now. And then make it brief and follow up with a formal email declining. Let them know that you'll do that, because often they need that for the file. And if you feel like you met some great people that you want to stay in touch with during the process, I would send personalized LinkedIn invitation connection requests to the people that you want to stay in touch with. But I would wait a little while. A good rule of thumb is about a month to make that request, because by then they will have gotten somebody in that role, hopefully. So here's a script for you to use, and you should send it via email unless you receive other instructions. So let them know, hey, thanks so much. I'm sorry to decline. Thanks so much for your consideration. Best wishes to you. So brevity wins. All right. Now another option is to accept the offer without changes. And there are reasons for doing this. I've had candidates say, you know, this is a very generous offer and I really feel good about it. I feel like they've already extended themselves, or they've expressed themselves, you know, that they really have stretched their budget and you recognize that there are other variables going on. So here's what you do. You just call them and tell them, yes, I'm in. Find out when you're supposed to report and anything you should do to prep. And then follow up the phone call with a formal email, because they'll usually need this to process your paperwork and get you onboarded. So let them know, I'm anticipating that you need to have this extra piece of paper. And so I'm gonna send that off to you. Is that what you would like? And also include anything that you agreed upon in the phone call, and just so that you have a written record of it, like the start date. And then celebrate. This is a big win. Whether you've declined the offer or whether you've accepted it as is, it's really a compliment to you that somebody has extended you this opportunity and recognized that you bring a lot of value. So you can celebrate in whatever way feels good for you. I'm a strong introvert, so this picture represents my celebration, but do it in the way that really fits for you.